Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be reviewing the HOVERAir X1 Autonomous Self-Flying Drone Camera. If you had to name two technologies that define the current era, it would have to be AI and drones. The new HOVERAir X1 drone combines the two into an impressive pocket-sized drone that can fit in your pocket and automatically track your motion with various built-in algorithms. Not only could this fit in your pocket, but you also launch it from the palm of your hand with autonomous flying modes and a single button press. In terms of packaging, this comes in a little plastic mailing envelope. And on the inside, you get this nice cardboard box with some basic branding printed on it. We have the combination. So you'll notice we have the camera, two batteries, and the charging hub. In terms of specs, this is $439. If you just want the camera, that's $389. We'll go ahead and take the camera out. You see really slick packaging, nice glossy illustration of the drone, and then the drone folded up. It really feels like a fancy cell phone with the slide-out sleeve design and really thick cardboard box. If we open this up, you can see it is a pocket-sized drone that can be literally launched from your hand. It has autonomous flying with multiple modes built in. It has a robust tracking algorithm with the five different modes that can do orbiting, bird's eye view, and other really cool effects without any training or complicated remote controllers. You have a nice camera on here, 2.7K video capture with 30 frames per second, as well as 1080 at 60 frames per second. There's a 32 gig internal memory card in here, with approximately 11 minutes of flight time for each battery. This only has a max height of 15 meters and a max speed of about 15 miles an hour. Instead of using GPS, you can also notice the bottom, there's a little bit of camera here. So this uses Visual Inertial Odometry, camera-based positioning algorithm, which eliminates the need for GPS signals or additional apps, so you can really just launch this within the matter of seconds. In terms of what comes with it, you can see we have the black variation, very small, literally fits in the palm of your hand. You have a nice little quick start guide here that tells make sure you fly this outside and gives you some basic instructions. Inside here, we also have a USB Type-C charging port, a nice fabric carrying case, which is pretty slick. So you can see this will fit inside it. Again, we have the combination. So this also comes with the charging hub and then additional batteries. So with only 11 minutes of runtime, you definitely want to get the combo, as the additional batteries will make sure you can get the most out of the drone. So we pull this out. You can see it's just another battery and that goes right on top. You can charge the battery directly on the device with the USB Type-C port on here, or use the charging hub, which can actually charge it at almost double the speed. Now let's take a look at the weight of the drone. So the drone with the battery attached, that comes in at only 127 grams, so really lightweight and very easy to carry. Just out of curiosity, a single battery comes in at 41 or 40 grams, so quite light as well. The HOVER X1 is a revolutionary drone camera that combines portability with a variety of technology to make flying quick and easy. This is a drone that doesn't require complicated controllers or training to learn to fly. Instead, you simply launch it from your palm of your hand and it'll automatically fly for you. It's also ridiculously small. You can see unfolded. It's only 127 by 145 by 30 millimeters, so very thin, and the longest dimension is less than 6 inches, so quite small. It also has this hinged body, so you can see the propeller sides hinge inward. And then you can fold this up to make it even smaller, and it'll fit in your pocket perfectly with these rounded corners that actually match the shape of a pocket. So pretty slick design, and it's amazing they've gotten this so small. You'll see that this has a standard quadcopter setup, so you have four propellers, and they rotate in clockwise and counterclockwise rotations to really ensure nice stability. And that means this drone can handle light wind pretty well. Because this drone isn't designed for high speed or high heights, it's only limited to 15 miles an hour and 50 feet altitude. That means all the blades are also covered in this plastic shroud. So on higher end drones, you'll never see this shroud, but with this one, it makes a lot of sense because I can actually hold it in my hand. And that means you can use this in crowded areas or places where a normal drone could be really unsafe, as this one is fully shrouded and doesn't present much of a danger. It's fully plastic designed too, so you can see quite flexible and should handle light falls pretty well. There are two colors with this one. We actually have the black one, but they also have an all-white variation that's pretty slick looking as well. The main body of this is this little rectangular centerpiece. You can see the little cutouts here for venting, as well as the bottom. You have that bottom facing camera that helps it locate itself, the front camera, the main battery, and then the user interface here. Starting with the battery, it's a pretty simple removable design. So you can see the grooves here. You pull up on it, and there's two tabs on the front that pull out. You can see this is a 10,050 milliamp battery. It's rechargeable, and you can recharge it on the device with the USB port here. Or I highly recommend getting that charging port with the combo, and this will actually charge in 35 minutes versus the on-device 55 minutes. So with this one, you can actually put this in a power bank, charge the other battery while you're flying the other one, and get a lot more flight time out of it. You can also press the power button once, and it'll actually show you the battery status, which is really cool. So you have four LEDs, and lets you quickly gauge how much flight time you have left. You can see the user interface is also very simple. You have two buttons here with this little ring of icons that show you the current mode. The power button is the bottom, and then the mode selection is the top. I'll go ahead and turn this on, so I hold the power button. And you get a lot of nice jingles and a nice British voice that tells you which mode you're in. So if I press the mode button.
Hover. Current mode, hover.
So it tells you exactly where you're on.
Activate your device with the hover app.
So you need to use the QR code here to actually connect the app to this to do the first flight. But you can see I can switch modes. And you can see the voice is very loud. There's actually no volume control, which would have been nice. So you can't really be very stealthy about this. If you're in public, you want to set up your mode before, or you'll definitely get some stares as this talks to you. To fly, you'd simply press the button again to fly, but I won't do that until I actually connect the app. You have a nice LED on the front, and that color of this actually tells you what state it's in and whether it wants to land. As far as the camera, you can see an integrated single-axis gimbal that can rotate up and down and help stabilize the image, as well as a little dampener built in, so you can see that'll dampen out some of the vibrations in flight. There's also electronic image stabilization that'll create really smooth images. So combining the gimbal with that EIS means you get very smooth images, even if it's light wind or you're running and the camera's going up and down. So pretty slick setup, and you can see this camera's capable of 2.7K at 30 frames per second or 1080 down to 60 frames per second. It's not the highest spec camera on the market, but for most social media and YouTube, it should be more than enough, especially at this price point. Compared to higher end drones, you're not going to be able to get commercial quality shots in 4K, 5K, but obviously you're paying the price for the portability of this. Now let's go over the main modes. You can simply select it by clicking the button.
Custom.
And then you'll hear the audio feedback. This is a very loud drone, so once you do the next button press, it turns on and you can hear the motors. So it's quite loud. You couldn't really do this in a public place as they will hear you. But you can see there's quite a few modes. This will be hover mode, so it acts as a tripod. And with the tracking on, it'll actually track your position as it holds its position. So a really nice feature, and it almost replaces the need for a tripod. And you get a nice smooth shot, whether you want a video or just an image. As you can see here, it lands as soon as you put your hand underneath it, so very simple.
Zoom out.
And you can see the color changes.
3 meters.
So zoom out will actually move away from you, and you can adjust the settings using the app to really fine-tune things. It captures two video clips. So you can see as it goes away from you, it'll capture one image, or one video. Then once it reaches the max distance, it'll then zoom back in so you get a second clip. It would have been nice if it was one clip, or with this one, you could stitch them together if you wanted to. Again, put your hand underneath it and it lands. So very cool. You don't really need the app at all.
Follow.
We'll show you follow later.
Orbit
will actually spin around you. So really simple. And again, you can adjust the settings with the app. So once you launch it, you'll see it'll adjust its position to the specified distance. And then you'll get the video as soon as it starts rotating. So this one, you get this nice rotational shot. And this is a great example of some of the obstacle avoidance as well. So as you can see here, it follows me around based on my initial position. And I'll actually hit some of the branches here. But then it self-corrects itself, adjusts its position, and continues with the orbit. at a slightly higher position. Then once it finishes that rotation, it'll actually come back, and then you can land it by putting your hand underneath it. So very simple, and this is all autonomous, so you simply press that button and it starts flying. There also is the bird's eye mode. And again, that British voice is very loud, so if you want to do this in public, you do have to be careful, as it's quite loud. So between the motors and the audio prompt, they'll definitely notice you. So with bird's eye, this actually go up and then back down, so you can see it's tracking me and then going into position. So it's a great shot if you want to capture redwood or the unique settings where you're lying on the ground. So again, it does two clips, one going out, then it'll end the clip there and then start descending. Now let's take a look at the app. Hover's done a really nice job making this app easy to use. You have four tabs on the bottom. You need to connect it once to activate the app. And after that, you can use it to customize the modes. This will also let you unlock some of the other modes. So it has a nice little tile setup where you can try each mode and then it'll unlock some of the other features. They're constantly changing this app as well. So you can see each mode has different settings. And as I said, they will add more settings as people ask for it. So you can see zoom out has a really nice animation of what it does. You can set the distance, altitude, video quality, vertical mode, all independently for each mode separately. So really nice, and you can customize it. Some of the other ones like follow, again, you can change the duration, distance, and the altitude as well as the follow mode, so whether it's in front of you or behind you. So really cool options, and you can really customize things exactly what you want to capture. And again, very easy to use, which is impressive given that it's a relatively small company. All the UI is simply designed. There's no misspellings or odd translation. Instead, everything's very intuitive, and you can really just customize it as you want or just leave it in the basic mode. Custom also lets you change it between the dolly track mode, which goes in front of you, and we'll show an example of that a little bit later, or the snapshot mode, which just acts as a photo taking mode. So the dolly track is one of our favorite. It actually gets very unique shots as it falls from in front of you. You can access all the captured video by just clicking the album, which will connect to the Hover Wi-Fi. We found it a lot easier just to connect our USB and then do a mass download. You can also do the manual mode. So using the app, you can actually manually fly this, which is really cool. So you can see here, it does a live preview of the video, nice high quality. You can start capturing video, and then you can do the takeoff directly from here. So from this, you can see you can do left, right, forward, backward. You can adjust the camera gimbal as well, so you can rotate the camera up and down. It's all really neat features, and using the manual mode, you can capture some of those traditional drone shots, like the cinematic rising shots or some of the landscape shots of the drone moving forward. Using just the phone, it is a little bit harder to use as you don't have joysticks. You can connect a remote control, but just using the phone, you can capture the basic up, down, or rotational shots. So you can see we have a nice ocean view here, and I can zoom in and out or do those nice cinematic shots. So really cool, and again, it's nice that Hover's added this feature. For most people, just using the autonomous mode works, but with this one, you can really capture some unique shots. So if you want to get a group gathering, you can use the manual mode to adjust it exactly where you want, and you have a live preview to stage everything properly. When you want to land it, again, you just bring it back, and the app also has a land option. So if you end up in a hairy situation where it's too high for you to put your hand underneath, you can press a button here and have it land directly. So overall, really easy to use, and you can customize everything to your exact preferences. Now let's take a look at some shots using the follow mode and dolly track features. This is a great example of the follow mode, so you can see it actually keeps me centered in the view, and I'll actually avoid all the trees even as I dive in and out of them, which is really impressive. Just by using the camera, it can do that obstacle avoidance. The only issue it has is with thin branches, or if you do an orbit where it can't actually see the object. If it does hit something, it'll immediately land and then give you a little scolding as well. So great, easy to use drone. And again, you can use this in a variety of settings. The follow mode also works very well. You can see it tracks you no matter where you go, and you can actually adjust the height and distance. The video quality on here is very nice as well. So you can see nice bright colors and very smooth image, so the image stabilization is done really well. It doesn't work in low light conditions, sand, or water, so you do have to be careful. That's one of the limitations of this vision-based height detection, so it can't really do things a GPS one could, but very impressive. The dolly track feature is also another mode in the custom setting. So this will actually follow in front of you at an angle. And you can see here, you get these really unique shots that you really couldn't get otherwise. And you can actually adjust the angle again by just adjusting your own position. So really impressive if you want to get content or just capture some unique moments. Manual mode is also really interesting. So you can use this to get cinematic shots. And just using your cell phone, you can get these kind of rising or angled shots to capture really cool settings. So overall, really nice drone. And because it's so small, you can take this places you normally couldn't. Take a larger drone or a big camera. So really impressive and portable. And whether you're doing sports or you just want to capture an activity, you can use this for just about anything. Now let's go over the pros and cons of the HOVERAir X1. What I like about it is the compact form factor. It literally fits in your pocket, which is really impressive given the image quality and the autonomous features. You also have that really impressive tracking and collision avoidance. So you can use this to track your position, whether you do it from the front or rear. And the drone does a very good job avoiding obstacles just using the camera. It also captures smooth and unique video. So you get 2.7K, and the motion stabilization is done really well. So whether you're running, hiking, or if there's a light breeze, the video seems to always come out nice and smooth. The main negatives with the drone is the fact that you have loud motor buzzing. It is very loud. HOVERAir kind of advertises this as a tourist-style camera to replace your selfie stick, but it's so loud that you're not going to be able to use this in a tourist destination without being thrown out, so you do have to be careful. The audio prompts are also very loud, and the volume cannot be currently adjusted, something other people have complained about, and I'm sure they'll adjust in the future. And finally, the memory on this is 32 gigs, and it's actually internal. There's no memory card to remove or expandable feature, which is one downside, but it is okay as you only have 11 minutes of runtime anyways. Taking everything into account, but to give the HOVERAir X1 a 9.7 out of 10, it's a very portable and powerful drone. Really impressed with all the autonomous features and just how easy it is to use. Thanks for watching this review. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can see more content from us on our website at thesweetcyclist.com, as well as follow us on Instagram at thesweetcyclist. This is The Sweet Cyclist reminding you to enjoy the ride.